If you ask a Pole, who is your national hero, he will say Chopin. Although Chopin left Poland when he was very, very young, I think he remained very much Polish, whether he liked it or not, to the end of his life. Polish, I mean, there's a certain charm, a certain elegance, but there's also a certain pride in the Polish people, which is very clear in this music. In the music, it comes out in a, I think, in a great feeling of rhythmical strength. In the piano music, he had a great variety of pieces. He wrote very major pieces, large pieces, sonatas, the F minor fantasy, which is also on this recording, the Barcarolle. These are major pieces with very interesting forms, each one of them. And then he also wrote smaller miniature pieces, which very often have a little touch of 19th century salon in them, but they are no less deep for that. And I've tried in this Warsaw recital to give as complete a picture of his style as I could. I played quite a lot of Chopin when I was very young. I played etudes and I played the second and third sonatas and many of the other pieces. But I never recorded the concertos. In fact, the number one I learned when I was very, very young and played it quite a lot. But the second concerto I learned after I was 60 years old, very young. I was very happy to be able to do that with the Staatskapelle and with Andres Nilsson, because it's not easy for the orchestras or for the conductor to really get into the style. There's no possibility of comparison. There are no symphonies, there are no symphonic poems, there are no operas. So either you really have studied thoroughly the musical idiom of Chopin in his piano pieces, or you don't really know this. And I must say, I found both the Staatskapelle and Andres Nilsson so attentive and so curious about many things. It was a particular pleasure for me. It was never my intention, nor Edward Said's intention, to found an orchestra. We wanted to find a forum where young musicians from the Middle East, from Israel, Palestine, and the other countries could come together and could establish a dialogue and hear the other's point of view. We thought of a small chamber music group, but we were absolutely dumbfounded when there were over 200 applications from the Arab world alone. And this is what made us do the orchestra. And then we looked after it. And from the already from the second or third year, the young musicians got scholarships. They studied during the year with professors from the Staatskapelle in Berlin. Then these were the coaches in the summer, the same people with me. Then we did the tour, and then they got wet again. So when they left in August and came back in July of the next year, they were 20 or 25% better by themselves. And this is what explains why it was possible in such a short time for them to play one of the most difficult pieces in their repertoire, the Schoenberg Variations, so well and so perfectly after only a few years of existence. And I'm very proud of the fact that we recorded that, and very grateful that this is coming out. And of course, the Pathetique of Tchaikovsky is one of the great symphonies of the repertoire, so it is our, if you want, our visiting card.